गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे वी विल रिवाइज चैप्टर 5 सेपरेशन ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस. अर्लियर वी हैव डन दिस चैप्टर बट फॉर द कमिंग टेस्ट वी विल रिवाइज इट अगेन. नाउ द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज सेपरेशन ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ सेपरेटिंग सब्सटेंसेस. डियर स्टूडेंट, इन योर सराउंडिंग यू विल फाइंड दैट substances are not in the pure form. They are generally combined with other substances. So, they are in the form of mixture. So, what is a mixture? Combination of two or more substances. So, from a mixture, you want some useful component and you want to remove harmful component. For this, separation is essential. So, why do we need to separate substances? To obtain useful components. Sometimes, to obtain useful component, we do separation from the mixture. For example, curd is churned to get butter and buttermilk. Buttermilk, which we call lassi in Hindi, buttermilk is also essential and butter is also required. So, to get both useful component, we want to use them separately. So, to get the useful component, we need to separate the substances from their mixture. And the second point is to remove harmful or unwanted components. For example, before cooking rice or pulses, if there are pebbles, some other grains or husk present in that rice or pulse, we used to remove them. Before cooking rice or pulses, we wash them to remove the dirt. So, why do we separate the substance? To remove harmful or unwanted components. So, I have told you two main reason behind separation of substances. Why do we separate substances? To get the useful components and to remove the harmful or you can say unwanted components. Right? Now, in this chapter, we will discuss some of the method of separation of substances. Different substances, they have different properties. Right? Different substances, they have different properties. That's why they need different method of separation. Some substances, they differ in size. For example, in a mixture, two substances are present. There may be difference in their size. There may be difference in their state. Any of the substance can be in solid, liquid or gas state. So, substances which are in the form of mixture, they are together in the mixture, they have different properties. On the basis of these properties, for their separation, different methods are needed. To separate different type of substances, different methods are used. Some of the methods of separation are given in your chapter. We will discuss them one by one. First of all, now we are going to discuss methods of separating substances. Methods of separation. I hope it is clear to you why do we need to separate substances? To get useful component and to remove harmful components. Right? Now the method of separation. The most common method which you can see around you is hand picking. This method is done when the impurities are in large size. When the size of impurity is large and the impurities they are in small amounts. So when the impurities they are in small amount and they are large in size, we can easily pick them by hand. For example, for cooking rice, before cooking rice or pulses, you might have seen your mother that she is picking out some stone, unwanted pebbles and some other grains or husk particle from the rice. So, by hand picking. Hand picking is a method in which we use our hand. We pick the impurities by our hand. And this method is convenient when the impurities, they are in large size and smaller quantity. When the impurities are in small quantity and they are in larger size, it is easily separated. separated by our hand. So hand picking, what is hand picking? To pick the impurities by our hand. And this method is convenient when the impurities are less in amount and they are bigger in size. Clear? Now the second method of separation. Second method of separation which we are going to do is threshing. You might have seen that after harvesting you will find bundles of stalk of grain. You might have seen bundles of stalk of grain lying in the field after harvesting. These bundle may be of wheat stalk or paddy stalk, paddy means rice. So you might have seen the bundles of wheat stalk in the field. So now there, along with this stalk, grains are there. Seeds of grains are there in those stalk. Now if we want to pluck any fruit from the tree, it is easy. For example, there is a tree of mango and you want to get the ripe mango, you can easily pluck the mango from the tree. If you want to get ripened guava from the tree, you can easily pluck them from the tree. But it is not easy to pluck grains from the stalk because they are smaller in size and their quantity is very large in that stalk. So due to small size of grain, we cannot separate them by the plucking method. So what we do threshing. In the threshing, the stalk of grain, they are beaten against hard object. Right? When we beat the stalk of grain against any hard object, grains, they separated out, they comes out. In this way, threshing is done. But nowadays, earlier it was done either by human power, or by with the use of bullocks. Using bullocks, threshing was done. Grains are removed from the stalk with the help of bullocks. But nowadays, the machine which we use to separate grain from stalk is thresher. So with the help of thresher, grains are separated from the stalk and the method is called threshing. So what is the meaning of word threshing? Separation of grains from their stalk is called threshing. I hope it is clear to you. Now the next method which we are going to discuss is winnowing. Winnowing. The grains which we obtained in the field, husk is also present with the grain. For example, if we take example of wheat, along with the wheat grains, husk is also present. So farmer, they adopt this method winnowing to separate grain from husk. So winnowing is a method which is adopted by farmer in the field to separate grain from husk. Grain are heavier, husk are lighter particle. So winnowing is a method in which your heavier particles, they are separated from lighter particles with the help of wind. Right? So winnowing is a method, generally it is used by farmer in the fields to separate grain from husk. So it is a method in which heavier particles are separated from the lighter particles with the help of wind. What the farmer do in the field? From a height near about their shoulder, they take the grains and from there, for example, you take a plate, put some grains and husk in that. Now from a height, you allow them to fall down. What will happen due to air? Lighter husk get blown away and the heavier grains, they fall on the platform where you are doing the winnowing. Clear? So winnowing is a method in which grains are separated from husk. Heavier particles are separated from lighter particles with the help of wind. Clear to everyone? What farmers do? From a height, they allow the grains and husk to fall down. Lighter husk blown away by the wind and the heavier grains, they fall down. In this way, separate heap, Heap means ढेर. Separate heap of grain and husk is formed. So winnowing is a method of separating heavier particles from lighter particles with the help of wind. For example, farmer they separate grains from husk using this method. Now the next method, which you see very commonly in your home also, that is sieving. In this method, a sieve is used. Sieve is a device, instrument having the pores. These pores are small in size and they allow the smaller. So sieving is a method which can be used when there are bigger size particle and smaller size particle, right? So by using the sieve, bigger particles and smaller particles are separated. In the sieve, we put the mixture of bigger and smaller particles. Smaller particles, they comes out from the sieve, and the bigger particles, big size particles, they remain in the sieve. So sieving is a method you can see at your home also. Your mother, she use sieve when she want to cook something from the floor. If she want to make a dish with the help of floor, so before using floor, she use sieve. The bran or husk or impurities, you can say, it remain on the sieve, and the small size particle of flour, it comes out of the sieve. I'm telling you again, in sieving, large size particles, they are separated from small size particle using a sieve. Right? Sieve has very fine pores, so it allow fine particles to come down. For example, before making any dish from a flour, your mother sieved the flour. She put the flour in the sieve, and the flour particles are fine. It comes out of the sieve, and the bran, or you can say impurities, they remain on the sieve. Clear? So these are the methods which are given in your book, which I have discussed with you. Remaining method we will discuss in the next video.